It's hard to find things to talk about with people that are dying. I mean, everything seems so pointless, but silence is worse. So I asked her why she'd never come for Christmas. She laughed. Busiest day of the year, love. Christmas Day, busiest day of the year. Lonely guys giving themselves presents. Though it's not the sex they're after, most of them. They just wanted someone to talk to and some company. Poor buggers. The brothel's still there, in Penrith, Sydney. I went there a short while after Gloria died, just to have a look. I pretended I was looking for a job, and I went there about 10 o'clock in the morning, and geez, it was exactly as I'd imagined it. It was this posh sort of parlour area, and then down this corridor, there was the shagging rooms, the shagging cubicles. Geez, they weren't much bigger than this box. I met a couple of the girls. They were nice enough, but they didn't give much away. I mean, not that there's many mysteries, I suppose. Were they happy? Well, I didn't ask. But the hoops made Barry happy. And that's another thing I learned from Barry. It didn't matter how many times I stuffed up, so long as I went on to a good, flashy finish. If I didn't, he'd be fractious and moody. So long as I went on to a proper ending, he'd be happy. I mean, the thing you can't do is finish on a mess. I mean, if a hoop flies off your arm or suddenly clatters to the ground, spoils the show, you can't just give up and stop. That'd be like finishing with Cinderella still scrubbing the floor. You've got to get it together. You've got to make it work. You've got to rise to the end. You've got to tie a neat little bow and fling Cinderella into the arms of Prince Charming. The punters need it. They've got enough failure and dissatisfaction at theirs. They don't come to a show to see more of it. I'll leave it at that.